And the ball's gone out. Gallen under a bit of pressure. Turns inside. Can he get a cross in? He can get a cross in. Furlong with a header. It's forward to Rowlands. Real chance. 1-0 Rangers. 1 minute on the clock. And Rangers take the lead. What a start for QPR. Could Martin Rowlands have sealed Super Hoop destiny for 2004?
After the grandstand opening, Rangers continued to press. First Gallen, and then Rowlands going close. And with it being the last game of the season, the players did their traditional lap of honour.
Gallen near post, receives it, he's going to flick it over his shoulder, he's got Ainsworth making a run towards the byline, here comes Ainsworth, crossfield ball, it's just bobbled into the path of Gallen, and it's been scored by Queen's Park Rangers, and Kevin Gallen, who said earlier this week he wants to score the goal that sends them up, 10 minutes before half time, has given them the chance. Gallen from 6 yards, his 17th of the season, the fans are in 7th heaven, Sheffield Wednesday 0, Queen's Park Rangers 1. Is that glory for him? Here's Kevin Gallen, scored the only goal of the game so far. Rolls it out wide to Bertram, cross in from him. Flicks in the air. Pearl Furlong takes on the chest. Furlong shot! Furlong scores for Queen's Park Rangers in the second minute of the second half. And Kevin Gallen did it in the first half. Furlong, who has been a magnificent centre-forward for the last 18 months, has done it at the start of the second. A great turn, a great shot. Pressman beaten. The first division gets ever so close now for QPR. Sheffield Wednesday 0, Queen's Park Rangers 2, and it's the dynamic duo who've done it so far. Gallen and Furlong, bang, bang.
Yeah! does it feel to be a Division 1 club?
Oh, it's fantastic. It's the best day in my life.
Best day in your life?
Yeah, and thank you very much for all QPR fans because they are great, and the QPR and the Loftus Road as well. And I would like to say thank you very much to my family in Argentina, my mom, my dad, my brother, sister, to my girlfriend. She's very important in my life. Te amo, Sio. I love you, my girlfriend.
I can't describe it. 14 years in the game, I was nearly in tears there, and I've never ever had a feeling like that. This club is taking me to the heights. I've done the same to them because they're fantastic fans. The gaffer, I'm so pleased he brought me here. I ran till I dropped today, knowing that there's 10 other lads out there who will run till they drop for me. And that's what this club's all about. And we're going to go to that division next year. We're going to get a right good go and see where we go. Wigan, Cardiff, Crewe, they've all survived this year. We're going to push. He says we can't do that. We're a good team. We've got some great players here. And the fans are fantastic. This club deserves bigger, and we're going to give it bigger.
What does it feel like, just in front of the fans? It's amazing.
It's unbelievable. I'm buzzing, man. It's the biggest gig I've ever played, and I love it. And I love those people out there. And I've done it for every one of them. And for that guy over there, you know, he's top, man.
Sorry to keep you waiting. Had a little celebration to do. It's just a tremendous feeling, you know. We've had such hardship ever since I took over, really. You know, the place had to be sorted out, and everybody's worked so hard to come from sort of seven fit players who were probably first team standard with no goalies at all. Carlisle and Langley long-term injured with no definite future whether they were going to come back or not, and you know, we've actually put things together, and everybody's played their part. And I have to say, I'd love to change our name if I could. We actually became Queen's Park Rangers United, and from the board down to the fans, you know, I've told them today, there was people, QPR fans at our hotel, and I wanted them to be part of the team talk. I didn't talk about Sheffield Wednesday, I just talked about us, and I wanted them to tell our lads how proud they would be even if we didn't do it today, and how proud they should be, because these boys have worked their socks off. There's people there that I can't tell you what this means to them, you know, and I'm so proud of them. They're going to go down in QPR folklore, and some of them really, really deserve to, in fact all of them. But you know, it's what you do next that counts, and we've got to move forward and do well. No one wants to go to the first division and struggle, so we've got to do like the other teams that went up this year and move forward.
Two seasons, really. We've been so consistent for two seasons. This lot deserve it.
from